can't let this vaccination plan go forward the way the Trump administration is designing it, because Biden can't undo it 2 months later. We'll be in the midst of it. And I've been talking to governors across the nation about that. How can we shape the Trump administration vaccine plan to fix it or stop it before it does damage?
That is New York Governor Andrew Cuomo yesterday saying it's bad news that Pfizer's COVID vaccine was shown to be 90% effective, all because it means it may be released while President Trump is still the president. Joining us to discuss, Dr. David Simati, a Newsmax medical contributor. He's also the author of The Ultimate Manual. Doctor, thanks so much for coming on today. What do you make of the governor's comments?
Well, I think it's good news and good news. And all the doctors and scientists are extremely excited about this news. Very important, Emma, that we need to keep politics outside medicine. We're dealing with people's lives, especially in New York, was hit really, really hard. We had some of the worst numbers of survival and the numbers of people that got the COVID virus. This is a light at the end of the tunnel. We are very excited to have this virus vaccine. It's also very important for people to know that this vaccine is not a Trump vaccine. All this criticism doesn't really help us at this point. It's important to also know that Mike Pence has worked extremely hard along with the president to bring this vaccine. The Warp Speed Project has been successful. Even though Pfizer may not have taken a lot of money from the federal government, they need all the distribution and the support and the weight of the government to get millions and millions of this vaccine out to public. This is a vaccine that's given two shots about 3 weeks away from each other. We're going to have 50 million of these available by the end of the year and 1.5 billion doses for 2021, which is exactly what we anticipated. And the president predicted this actually not too long ago. It's a little disappointing that this news comes a week after the election, but it's okay. We're dealing with people's lives and we'll take the fact that it has 90% efficacy.
Right.
And Emma, we can cover our nursing home, elderly, people that are vulnerable. This really puts a big dent on lockdown and mandatory mask. It's a huge news for the country and we should celebrate it.
Yeah, absolutely. Love that optimism, as always, from you, Dr. Simati. So when we're learning that it's 90% effective, how common is that? I mean, that sounds pretty good.
It is unusual. We really expected to see somewhere between 50 to 60%. And so this is tremendous outcome. And this is also reviewed by a third party that are reviewing the safety mechanism of this. So this is great news. Also, Lilly is coming with another great news of people who have been already been infected by the virus. They're able to get some antibody boost in order to get them through this disease. And Moderna is also going to come up with some really good news. So fasten your seatbelt, because over the next 2 months, you're going to get great, great news from all these clinical trials. By the way, this is something that it's never heard of, to see these fast clinical trial outcomes in a country like this. And America is absolutely leading this research, and a lot of other countries are purchasing these vaccines from us. So I think all in all, we're going to see hopefully an end to this virus, yeah, and we can move on with our open up our economy and move on with our life.
So many people, really, they're ready for that. Absolutely. Okay, I do want to ask you about a plan, or at least part of a plan, that was provided by Joe Biden in regards to how he would tackle the coronavirus here. The headline from his plan is a nationwide mask mandate. That's part of it, at least. He also wants to renew ties with the WHO, relaunch a pathogen tracking program, among a few others. But again, that nationwide mask mandate, how do you think he could actually go about enforcing that?
Well, it's very difficult. And I think that a lot of European countries already had mandate on masks, and we see that it didn't work. We can see the numbers in Europe is actually on the rise again. So while this is all nice and cute, it really is not necessarily practical. And I think that, you know, going back to WHO, unless they're really going to fight for American lives, WHO is supposed to be a World Health Organization, not particular different countries. And I think that we, all of these organizations, need to put politics completely out and concentrate on the medical aspect of it. Then it would be reasonable to participate and pay our fair share and not for other countries. I think, you know, chasing this story for the last 9 months, especially with Newsmax, and I want to congratulate everyone because so many people are coming to Newsmax because they're getting the true news. We see that the president and vice president have done everything in their power to make sure that we defeat this virus. Mm. The economy is coming back. We are holding control of this disease. Vaccine is coming. We have a lot of therapeutic medications. We are able to diagnose people early on, treat them. And I understand there are a lot of people that are anti-vaccine. I understand that, but it's fairly safe, and we need to respect people. Mandates in this country doesn't work, Emma. Mandatory mask, mandatory vaccine, anything that starts with mandatory, unfortunately, in this country, it doesn't work, so we need to respect it. But, of course, we need to put the lives of vulnerable people that are elderly, who have comorbid disease in nursing home. We need to protect them, and this will give us that chance.
Right. And so I heard you mention you credited the Trump administration's coronavirus task force for what they have achieved in regards to combating the coronavirus. Of course, this vaccine development is just the latest there. But I want to compare and contrast that to the plan presented by Joe Biden's administration, should he indeed be sworn in on January 20th. And in fact, Assistant Secretary for Health Admiral Brett Giroir was asked yesterday about Joe Biden's COVID testing strategy. I want to show you this. And apparently, he